The community and the Steam Deck aftermarket have been coming up with loads of awesome mods and customizations for the Steam Deck, and I'm going to catalog and showcase as many as I can. Let's get into it. What's good, Deck Gang? This is a video that I've been really excited to make. The community has been hard at work ever since before the launch of the Steam Deck. I remember folks coming up with concepts for kickstands and attachments for SSDs and power banks, even before we had Valve's own 3D files. This is something that's a little unique to the Steam Deck as a console, if you want to call it that. Steam and Steam Deck as an extension is a platform that basically encourages you to have it your own way, with things like Steam input and now performance profiles. Not to mention the fact that it's a PC. PC inherently means customizability as well as the ability to tinker. That makes me certain that the Steam Deck is going to be the most customizable gaming handheld ever, or at least a gaming handheld with the biggest modding community. So that's what I'm going to showcase in this video. Hardware mods, software mods, and other customizations for the Steam Deck. I'll have links in the description, and in the case of things that are for sale, they are probably going to be affiliate links so I get a small commission on those, but all of the opinions I'm providing are my own. I'll also have chapters in the description if you want to skip around to different areas, but as we get started, folks, please be sure to smash the like button. It really helps this video spread to more people, and if you do like this video, consider subscribing and setting your notifications to all. Alright, let's jump in. First, let's talk about skins and decals. Dbrand has some really good but pricey skins, and if you want something more affordable, well, I know a couple people that have you covered. First up is TouchProtect. These aren't full skins actually, but instead they're vinyl decals that are specifically for the touchpads. They help protect the touchpads, which hopefully adds to the shelf life of the console as a whole, but more importantly, they have a texture to them that makes them tactile. I like the way these feel, especially considering how much I use the touchpads for shooters. There are a few different options for colors and textures. For textures, there's hex, mini hex, and carbon. I like them all, but I've become partial to the mini hex. It's softer to the touch than the hex, but it's still quite tactile. It should be fairly obvious, but it's important to note that these decals don't interfere with the usage of the touchpads, including the haptics. They're also very straightforward to apply. There was one decal for me that was really adhered to the backing paper pretty strongly, but you can use a knife to pry it off well enough. These are very affordable at $13 for the pair, and probably worth buying even if you're getting a full skin, again, thanks to the tactile feel. Next, I want to talk about these custom skins by Moskeeto. Moskeeto is a really avid member of the Steam Deck community. He's in the Steam Deck subreddit, Discord, and he's active in the Fan to Deck Discord too. He's also helped me out with this channel from time to time, and he has his own really helpful videos, especially for using Steam input on the Steam Deck. So yeah, check him out. Anyway, he has 3 designs for sale on his Etsy page. I'm rocking the Portal one since Valve won't make the Portal deck yet. I really dig this. It's a minimal white design with the Aperture logo on the left grip, the Portal logo on the right, and of course the dude jumping through an orange portal on the touchpad coming out of the blue portal on the other touchpad. I love that. The back is clean with just an Aperture logo, and if you like, Moskeeto also includes a few extras. There are portal related icons, plain white grips, and companion cubes for the trackpads, but you can see I'm still rocking my mini hex designs. Moskeeto is also selling a Half-Life themed skin as well as a creeper design that Gardner Bryant suggested. I like both of these, but the Minecraft creeper is just so damn good. I don't play Minecraft, but I think I'm going to get this skin next. What do y'all think? This was my first time installing a skin and I was worried, but it was easier than I thought. Moskeeto has an unlisted video that walks through the entire process. He has really helpful tips on how to apply it, like for the front panel where he suggests only taking a small piece of the backing paper off so that you can apply the initial piece of the skin and make sure it's all aligned before applying the rest. Also, you'll need a hairdryer. A heat gun would be even better, but I didn't have one, so I just used a hairdryer. That helped make sure it was a really snug fit and it helped flatten out the crimped edges. I had to go over it twice because I didn't use enough heat the first time. Moskeeto did say I should get it to the point where it's almost a little too hot to the touch. And yeah, that did the trick. Anyway, these are also really, really affordable. They're $25 a pop. I told Moskeeto they're worth even a bit more than that, but he's a good dude that refuses to raise the price, so consider picking one up. All right, let's talk about some software mods before I jump back into more hardware-oriented stuff and 3D printed accessories. I'm only going to showcase one software mod, but it's a big one. It's called the SteamOS plugin loader. It presents a whole new item in the quick access menu, and from there you can install and manage various plugins from the plugin browser. For what it's worth, I present this with some major caveats. Notably, this is running unofficial code that I personally haven't audited, nor do I intend to. Naturally, neither has Valve. It can be a little bit janky. The same is true for some of the plugins. Additionally, some plugins require root access. One of the plugins allows you to even control the fan curve, so you can see the potential danger there if you don't know what you're doing. Also, some plugin functionality may break with updates to SteamOS. So just be aware that these tools are generally for more advanced users, and I'm presenting them here as an indication of what is possible. That said, this thing is sick. It's really perfect for power users. The installation instructions are fairly straightforward. You have to enable developer mode and remote debugging. Then you just run the installation script using the command. Again, I recommend that you be able to read and understand what an installation script is doing before running it. And that's why I recommend this for power users first and foremost. There's also a very handy uninstall script as well. Once installed, you can control it only with touch so far, but if you tap the store button, it will take you straight to the plugin browser. Just double tap on the install button on any one of these plugins and you'll get a prompt to install that plugin. There is a tag in the plugin browser to denote which plugins require root access, so do pay attention to that. Now, let me tell you about some of these awesome tools. First is the calculator. Now you can have a calculator right in your quick access menu, which is an awesome proof of concept, but also might be helpful for anyone playing EVE Online or something like that. Maybe the most useful of these plugins is the power tools. If you've seen the pre-release video where the Fox was parking cores on the Steam Deck, then you know precisely why it can be helpful. But the short version is that if you have a constrained power envelope like you do on the deck, and then you reduce the number of cores in use, you will in practice increase the clock speed of the remaining cores, which can get you an increase in frame rate. So as far as I know, the Fox was doing this via CLI commands, maybe using SSH, but with this Power Tools plugin, you can do the same thing right from the quick access menu. And this is kind of exemplary of why the plugin loader is so cool. It shows that something like this is possible for Valve to do, perhaps in a future update. And I also want to shout out the Bluetooth plugin, because there's been a few times I wanted to reconnect a known Bluetooth device and didn't want to dig through the settings menu. The Bluetooth plugin is perfect because it lets me do it in fewer clicks from the QAM, so that's nice. Sadly, those are the only ones I can recommend right now. I tried a few others that I really wanted to show off, but I couldn't get them to work. SP Deck should allow you to control Spotify. Quick Launch lets you launch non-Steam apps without having to add them to Steam. That's especially neat for something like Proton Up, which I use fairly often, but hate having to go back to the desktop to do so. And finally, the CSS loader, which allows you to create your own theme for the Steam game UI, including a theme inspired by the classic puke green Steam interface. This one was created by Negative Ion. But like I said, I had trouble getting these to work, so I can't recommend them at the moment. In any case, the possibilities are pretty endless. I imagine you could theoretically create a plugin that allows you to add more resolutions to the Steam Deck. I've seen a script floating for that around. Or maybe add a plugin to sync files using a sync service. This could be helpful for non-cloud saves, for example. I can't wait to see what the community continues to cook up with the plugin loader, and I'd like to see Valve create their own plugin system for the Steam Deck. Alright, next up are some 3D printed accessories. I've seen docks and kickstands and hard drive holders, but today I want to showcase a clip-on system that does all of the above. These are by friend of the show Mike Brum, and he's calling the system the Steamclip. He's selling these on Etsy, so I'm including links in the description. The main apparatus is this 3D printed backplate that fits right on the back of the Steam Deck and smartly leaves room for all the vents. Then there are a number of attachments that basically clip onto that backplate. The first is an adjustable stand. You line up the slots, push inward, and you'll hear the satisfying click. At the top, there's a lever that you pull to release the attachment. Similarly, this kickstand attachment has a lever that you pull to release or close the stand, Once you have the desired orientation, you let go of the lever and you're good to go. The Steam Deck is now standing. Now, this is pretty bulky for an adjustable stand, but you know, what's cool here is that the system itself is modular, so I can remove the stand and clip on something else. Let's try the power bank attachment. Yeah, this is great. The power bank itself is heavy, so unfortunately it feels like I'm holding two Steam Decks, but I can charge while I'm playing without being tethered to a wall, so that's awesome. And yeah, if you want something lighter, you're going to need a smaller power bank. Okay, what else can we try? How about an attachment for my portable drive? Maybe I can load Windows on an external drive, and boom, I now have a comfortable way to dual boot. Or I can load up my ROM collection and run it from here, or whatever. It's an external drive, you get the idea. Finally, there are these universal wall mounts. So you screw this into a wall and you can slide a USB hub in here and then connect the Steam Deck to it. Then this smaller wall mount is for accessories like the SSD. That way you can connect the dock to the SSD, but you can still take the SSD on the go when you take your deck on the go. This can make a nice setup if you want to use your Steam Deck as a desktop replacement, for example. Now, all the things I mentioned that hold an accessory, they're tailored for a specific model of that accessory. The wall mount with this model dock, this SSD holder is for a specific drive, the power bank clip has a set width, it should be compatible with multiple banks but not thinner ones, for example. Also, like I mentioned, this can be a fairly bulky system, but I just really like that it's modular. By the way, you can fit the Steam Deck with this clip in the Steam Deck case. That seems to work just fine. But yeah, check out the Etsy page if you're interested in any of these. Finally, let's talk about some hardware mods. I've seen so many awesome hardware mods already. I can't demo these because I haven't done any of them, but I thought this would be a good place to catalog them. So the makers of TouchProtect, they're working on these custom D-pad and buttons. They're still in a prototype phase, but it seems like multiple colors will be available. Combine these with skins, and it's like the entire external look of your Steam Deck will eventually be customizable. In any case, they have a mailing list if you want to be notified when this product is ready. I'll certainly be keeping an eye on it. On the subject of buttons, there was a video about a month back of someone replacing the Steam and QAM buttons. Now, these buttons are one of the worst things about the Steam Deck. I really wish they had a more tactile feel, both on the surface and when you press them. Well, this mod makes them clicky, which is perfect. As they said though, it's not for the faint of heart, as it does require some serious soldering skills in addition to the needed teardown. But look, it goes from this to this. I love it. Similarly, there is an aftermarket vendor named GullyKit who seem to be working on some Steam Deck goodies. They tease some hall sensor analog sticks. These are still capacitive, by the way, and being hall sensor means that in theory they should never experience analog stick drift. They also seem to affirm that they are working on dual stage triggers for the deck, or maybe just aftermarket triggers in general, I'm not sure. And finally, Extreme Rate indicated that they are working on shell replacements for the Steam Deck, which is good because I need that atomic purple shell immediately. So yeah, there's a lot going on in the Steam Deck community. Custom skins, cool plugins, 3D printed accessories, custom component replacements, and a lot more to come. Pretty soon, your Steam Deck could very well be half Valve components and half custom pieces, and that's pretty freaking sick. But let me know what you think in the comments. Do any of these pique your interest? Also, if you like this video, then don't forget to hit the like button. And I'm going to be reviewing some non-deck hardware soon, so make sure to subscribe and set your notifications to all if you really want to watch that. Alright, until then, Deck Gang out. Goodbye!